High School Band Vice President of the Southeast Missouri Music Educators Association between the Tiny High School All District Band Coordinator, and that's not a job that I will be claiming on my taxes or anything, but it is. It has many benefits I found today just watching these groups work and reap the benefits of the hard work that they've done. This is this all started just 2.5 short weeks ago with our auditions, which I just have a couple of things I want to thank a few people before we get started. But our auditions were hosted at Jackson High School on November 2nd, and I'd really like to take time to thank the Jackson School District and their administration and their custodial staff for hosting that event, as well as we sit now in the Kinder Performance Hall, which is a beautiful facility. So I'd like to extend my thanks to the Cape Central School District for hosting this, their administration, their custodial staff, and of course their band director staff. They've been on hand all day handling all everything we needed. We just really appreciate having Mr. Lamar, Mr. Keys, Mr. Harrer, and then our Jackson staff that helped us out so much with their hosting our auditions, Mr. Broussard, Mr. Fleege, Ms. Mazzico, Ms. Boyd, and Mr. Brockman, who's also been on hand tonight, helping out with all percussion needs that we needed. So just take a moment, please, to help thank those wonderful. Thank you. I'd also like to make sure that we take time to thank the band directors that we have here that put so much work in, the students themselves for putting the work in to achieve excellence at this young age, and of course our clinicians, who I'll introduce in a moment as we get started here. So the junior high all district band that you see on stage in front of you is under the direction of Mr. Paul Holson. Paul Holson has recently retired from the Parkway School District. He's spent 30 years teaching junior high bands and is also a member of the 566 Air Force Band, which he's a senior master sergeant at that group and has performed all over the world with Air Force bands. And we have just been really grateful to be able to work with him today and see what he can do with these very talented, wonderful students. So please help me welcome Mr. Paul Holson and the junior high.
Yeah. Thank you very much. What a great group of young people here. Let's give them another round of applause. So we had a wonderful day of rehearsal, and it's quite a long time for young people to rehearse, but they were so well behaved and really enthusiastic about what we were presenting. And we think we have a lovely program for you this evening. That was called Cimarron Fanfare, and I told the students that area, Cimarron, is really close to Philmont, if you are familiar with the Scouts. And so it's a really cool kind of western town, and that kind of captures, the music kind of captures the feel of that town. The next tune that we're going to do is brand new. It was just composed this year in 2021 by Randall Standridge, and it's called Nebula. We were talking a little bit about space, and there's people in this group who really know more about space than I do. But we talked about nebulas and what their function is. And so there's several different kinds of nebulas, but most of them are kind of like star nurseries or star incubators. So it's a big collection of matter and gases and some young stars, and it's where they grow up to be big stars and new stars. And one of the kinds of nebulas is where stars disappear. But most of them, I said in the rehearsal, kind of like this room, it's a star incubator. So this is a beautiful, kind of floaty, spacey theme tune by Randall Standridge called Nebula.
Thank you.
you very much. It's really been my privilege to work with these young people all day, and they are parts of really fantastic band programs. And I'd love to thank the band directors who showed these young musicians how to play an instrument, Ms. Boyd for being an incredible host and taking care of all the logistic elements of doing an honor band, having auditions, and everything associated with this. I'd just like to give all of those directors a round of applause. Thank you. And these guys are so happy to be here after a really long day of playing. We're towards our final piece. And I just want to thank you all again for being such wonderful parents. I have four kids. They were all involved in the band and choir and orchestra. And so I commend you guys for making it such a priority and even pushing them when maybe they didn't want to be pushed and helping them excel when they wanted to excel. And so it's such a treasure to be able to play music in a live setting in a beautiful auditorium like this, but also just to interact with other people in a live setting. I think we'll all agree with that. So wonderful. I'm glad everybody's back doing honor bands and things of that nature. We're so excited to hear the high school. So our final piece is entitled Declaration of Blue. It has kind of an odd story, very briefly. It's jazz influenced, but there's not really any specific elements of jazz or improvisation, but it has blues scale elements present. It'll feel jazzy. And it was written in the early part of 2002 by Robert W. Smith, who wanted to do something that was going to, right after 9/11, obviously, right? But he wanted to kind of crystallize the feeling of enthusiasm and energy and transfer that to a piece of music that really just explains through music just all of the vitality of young people. So this is called Declaration. Thank you.